I will
Now
present you the
present.
main topic of my research, access. I work actually on a theoretical and experimental study of materials, 2D materials, materials as antimonene allotropes. Second, okay. The main topics are these. iPad. Graphite is a parallel honeycomb carbon sheets, light bonded with van der Waals forces. In 2004, Game and Nobel's Love were the first to exfoliate graphite, giving 2D material named graphene, with super properties different from graphite. In 2010, they won a Nobel Prize. Since 2004, many researchers have invested themselves in discovering relevant properties of these materials, such as the band structure, present Dirac cones, resulting on a linear electronic band structure near Dirac points, just like photons, which gave rise to Dirac physics materials. Graphene presents remarkable physical properties, such as it is light, rigid, perfect thermal and electrical conductor, 100 times stronger than steel, transparent with various allotropes and various properties for each allotropes. This success of graphene encouraged the exfoliation of new van der Waals materials. So large 2D materials and their allotropes were discovered, such as silicene, germanium, and other from the fourth, third, fifth, and sixth column of periodic table. Also, we can find polyatomic 2D materials, such as transition metal decalcogenide, hexagonal boron nitride, and recently perovskite and spinels 2D materials. These materials can be insulator, semiconductor, half metal, or semiconductor, according to their the materials and the allotropes. These materials are used in electrochemistry, such as photocatalysis, electrocatalysis, photovoltaics, batteries, and super capacitors. They also be used in as a sensor. 2D antimony can be exfoliated to give different sheets of antimony. These materials can present several allotropes, flat antimonene or packed antimonene or buckled antimonene. The theoretical study of these materials is conducted by using a density functional theory, which allow to determine structure, crystalline structure, band structure, and the density of state of many body systems. The DFT method is implemented in quantum espresso computer codes. This code is free. The different electronic structure is determined for several antimonene allotropes. we see here the band structure of alpha antimonene and of beta antimonene. The two materials are semiconducting and direct semiconducting materials. Also, the phonon's energy dispersion is determined. This relation of dispersion allow us to determine if the material or if this structure is stable or not stable, and allow us to determine the lattice thermal conductivity. Electronic transport properties also studied for the most material in different allotropes. We use the Boltzmann transport formalism implemented in Boltrap. This code, based on Boltzmann transport equation, using the band structure from the quantum espresso code, used to determine the electron transport coefficients such as the Seebeck coefficient, the electrical conductivity, the thermal conductivity, etc. In this code, the approximation used is the relaxation, is the constant time relaxation. We presented the following. The some results. In these figures, we have a comparison between graphene and flat antimonene conductivity. We see that the flat antimonene conductivity is greater than graphene with the same behavior with temperature. In the following slide, we present the Seebeck coefficient, which is defined as the voltage gradient produced in a material by a given temperature gradient when no electrical current flow in it. In these figures, we can conclude that graphene and antimonene Seebeck coefficients have the same, have different sign, and their absolute value present the same behavior. They increase with temperature and reach a maximum value according to chemical potential. The figure of merit is a thermoelectric efficiency of material depending on Seebeck coefficient, electrical conductivity, thermal conductivity, and the temperature. We can see that the thermoelectric efficiency of beta antimonene is greater one. The spin orbit interaction is also taken into consideration. Band structure of antimonene flat or packed are more influenced by spin orbit interaction than the graphene. However, the electrical conductivity is also influenced by spin orbit interaction for low temperature in the case of flat antimonene and for high temperature for graphene and packed antimonene. The multilayer and heterostructure of 2D materials and their electronics and electrical properties are also studied. We present in the following some conclusion in this study. The multilayer
1 minute left.
Okay. The multilayer effect is visualized in an opening energy gap in the flat bilayer, and the energy gap in bilayer decreases with the increase of interlayer spacing. 2D quantum dots is also studied. We can see that the translation symmetry is lost for quantum dots of antimonene. The energy gap is greater than in the case of a sheet. 2D materials. The synthesis of antimonene and different allotropes are also determined by using a liquid phase exfoliation consisting in mixture of material and an adequate solvent. After we use ultrasonication, step, and the centrifugation is necessary to separate the exfoliated part from the non-exfoliated material. The characterization need.
Your time is up, Brahim.
I read the conclusion or I stop?
Well, you can go right ahead to the conclusion. I can give you just less than 10 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Conclusion and perspective. Graphene and antimonene allotropes, monolayer, bilayer, 2D quantum dots, heterostructure, electronic properties with and without spin orbit interaction are studied. Electrical and thermal transport properties with and without spin orbit also is studied for different allotropes. This theoretical study is based on DFT and Boltzmann transport equation implemented in quantum espresso and Bolstrap packages. The synthesis of 2D materials is realized using liquid phase exfoliation. The application of these 2D materials is in energy harvesting triboelectric nanogenerators, and in perspective, we project to use new 2D materials and the applications in solar cells and in purification of water, drug administrations. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention.